I want to start this off by saying this new series I'm making, this as a filmmaker, is strictly from a filmmaker's point of view, as well as part of the audience. So when I point out mistakes or something that I absolutely adore about a film, it is from a perspective of a person that makes short indie films and aspires to make feature films. So to quickly answer some people in the comments, yes, people can make mistakes, but when you have people that look up to you in a certain aspect and others that pay you millions to make something, you make sure that you make it as pristine as possible. Someone said shit happens. Yes, it does. I get that. Since I make most of my shorts and other videos on a $0 budget, if something I shot got messed up or it doesn't look right, I either cut it or try to do a reshoot. But since they have a big budget for films like Six Underground, that shit you speak of can be fixed. With that being said, this video critique or essay or whatever you want to call it is on one of my favorite movies, Baby Driver. It's hard for me not to fanboy over Edgar Wright. He's hands down my favorite director, and I believe to be one of the most underrated directors ever. I love when movies have every detail of every scene thoughtfully built. Let me give you an example of what I mean. When I'm filming car events, it's rare that I have audio included in my raw recordings. I have to do what's called creating the environment. So I look at what's included in the B-roll and think about the sounds that it makes. If I don't have audio of the cars, I find some online. Is it the beach? Beach has oceans, kids, and wildlife, etc. I combine all of those sounds and create my scene's environment. It's pretty much starting with a blank canvas and adding in everything you want and taking out what you don't want. In Edgar Wright's case for Baby Driver, he builds the environment. He built his environment around a script and an ideal based on their protagonist. We find that out in the opening of the scene before there's even a picture on the screen. Eventually in the movie, we learn that our protagonist baby has tinnitus, and in the first scene, we have two things happening here that I find brilliant. One, we have the violin playing into the tone of the brake squealing. With that, we hear the tinnitus, the little high-pitched sound that plays in the back. That blew my mind the second time I watched this movie. It's one of those things that inspires me from Edgar Wright. Every time you watch one of his movies, you catch something you didn't see in the first, second, or third time. Throughout this whole film, you can hear it subtly in the background. This movie also does something you don't see a lot of filmmakers doing. It's something I get complimented on a lot, and get told people do it wrong a lot. That thing is cutting to the beat. If you don't know what that means, it's literally cutting to the beat of the music. It's so simple, but people mess it up a lot. It's one of those things that you don't notice if done right, but it's god-awful if you mess it up even slightly. You notice this theme throughout the whole movie. Here comes my favorite part, the first car chase. If you want to have a good car chase, you have to watch this scene and take notes. There are not a lot of cuts, and when there are cuts, they match up to the music. Every action matches with the music. Although it isn't a song I would have chose for a car chase, it is still spectacular and gets the blood pumping. I'm going to let out a little bit of my inner car nerd, so here's a fun fact. They use multiple versions of the Subaru WRX for the stunts, and for one of them, it was rear-wheel drive. For those that aren't car savvy, Subaru WRXs are normally all-wheel drive because they are rally cars or primarily used for off-road driving and racing. It is really hard to drift these with stock horsepower unless it's raining, snowing, or you're driving in the dirt. So the best way to pull these stunts off is with a rear-wheel drive car. I don't know why they specifically chose this car. I personally would have chose a BMW 335i. You can probably find an E90 BMW for the same price, if not cheaper, and wouldn't have to modify the drivetrain in order to pull these stunts off, other than changing out the differential for a limited slip differential, which would still come out cheaper than making a WRX rear-wheel drive. You possibly wouldn't even need multiple stunt cars as long as they aren't crashed. Enough car talk for a second. When they get away and Baby goes to get coffee, the song that plays, which I thought was Jump Around at first, has lyrics that is subtly and uniquely embedded into the film. Some of it is even written on the walls. Also, the ambiance from this scene matches the music as well. When Baby is ordering, he even contemplates his orders to the music, even though he knows what he wants already. Classic. Someone mentioned this to me, and I see it as unique storytelling, but also something that goes unnoticed. He was happy and worry-free on his way from the heist hideout, and the music sounds a little positive. But on his way back after seeing the girl that he likes, he runs into trouble, leading to a life he didn't want to live. And the music key changes to sound a little bit more menacing. There are plenty of ways to tell and progress a story. This doesn't have to be through dialogue only. Silent films did it through music and action. You can also do that with color. It was foreshadowed in this that when Buddy sees red, he is relentless and brutal. This actually shows when Buddy is trying to kill Baby. Buddy was in a cop car with a red ceiling light on and is going berserk trying to kill Baby. Now that's good storytelling. I'm not breaking down this whole movie, just the parts that stand out to me. The one blooper and scene that kind of stood out to me and I didn't know how they pulled it off without injuring the talent is the scene where Baby's glasses got smacked off. You can kind of tell it was shot multiple times because there's a scratch on his face that wasn't there before and is being covered by makeup. I don't know how I could do that scene differently without injuring Baby more than he already was, if not less. I know that's something small and probably pointless to point out, but these are some things that stand out to me as a filmmaker. And as a filmmaker, this movie makes me happy and inspired and motivated to create bigger and better car chases. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and help us reach 1,000 subscribers. I am Matt DeFord, and as always, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time.